10% skill, 15% concentrated power of will, 5% pleasure, 50% pain, and 100% reason to remember the name. He doesn't need his name up in lights, he just wants to be heard, whether it's the beat of the mic.
My name is Chris Kerber, and I'm a personal trainer at Retro Fitness in Ramsey, New Jersey. So when I was born into a pretty terrible situation. My mother was a drug addict. My father, I never met him. I grew up in a very abusive situation where my mother's boyfriend would, you know, burn me, beat me, lock me in a closet all day while she was at work. It wasn't until I was about 2 years old where I was with one of my aunts and she noticed all the scars on me and realized that I was getting abused. So she took me away, never gave me back. I got adopted. Moved out to Nevada for a few years, lived a normal life, and then I ended up in South Jersey where I got into a lot more trouble. Started when I was 10 years old and the father that raised me passed away in my living room. My mom worked jobs to keep a roof over my head, so I had no guidance and I was surrounded by a lot of negative things, negative people, drugs, gang, crime, violence, and you know, just had no one there to show me what was right and wrong, so I made some pretty bad choices. Got kicked out of school, was in and out of juvenile detention, in and out of courtrooms, constantly arrested. Just not a good head on my shoulders at all up until the accident, and then everything changed after the accident. I was 17 years old when I was in a near fatal accident. I was driving a van and I fell asleep behind the wheel, woke up. First thing I saw was the speedometer said 50 miles an hour and I was on a curb. So I swerved off the curb. The van rocked back and forth, flipped over a few times, and went into a telephone pole. Snapped the telephone pole in half, and all the power lines came down and wrapped the van while I was rolling. And then I ended up in a tree, and when I woke up, I couldn't move. I thought I was just, you know, stuck in my seatbelt. I took my seatbelt off, had my friends try to pull me out, and I wasn't going anywhere. And then I looked down at my leg, and I saw that it was through the firewall of the van, stuck in the engine, and bleeding immensely. I looked down at my leg and I realized it was stuck, and I said to myself, there's no way you're gonna make it out of this van alive. They kept telling me to stay with us, we're gonna get you out, we're gonna get you out, but every time I looked down at my leg and saw the pool of blood getting bigger, I kinda lost hope. You know, 17 years old and your life is over. I thought that the last thing I was gonna see was that pool of blood and my leg stuck in the engine. All your dreams of being an athlete and going to school and doing something with yourself were out the window. Well, when I got to the hospital, I woke up and the first thing I saw was a bright light. So I had immediately thought that I had died. When I realized that I was in the hospital, they took off the blanket from my leg and I realized how bad it actually was. They had told me, we're gonna have to amputate your leg if you do survive. Because mind you, I had lost more than 70% of my blood, so I had to get many blood transfusions and many surgeries. I was in the hospital for a few weeks, 2 or 3 weeks. Countless surgeries, skin grafts, taking skin from my left quad and putting it over my shin where the scar is. After about 3 weeks, they wanted me to try and get up on crutches to go home, but I got up on the crutches and all the blood from my body went down to my leg and it was the most painful thing in the world. So they put me in a wheelchair. I remember them telling me, you're probably gonna be stuck in this wheelchair for the rest of your life. We don't know if you're ever gonna be able to put that kind of pressure or your body weight on your leg. So I kind of accepted it. I was grateful to be alive. So I left the hospital in a wheelchair. I was in a wheelchair for about 4 or 5 months. I want to say. I felt like giving up when I was in the van. I felt like giving up when I was in the hospital. When I got home, you know, being wheeled around in a wheelchair with your friends every day, it's kind of, you're grateful to be alive, but it hurts to not be able to do normal things. Like a normal person, 17 years old, you want to run around and play, and you can't do any of that. So every day I would try to put a little bit more pressure on my leg, and a couple weeks would go by and I was able to limp. You know, walk around with a limp, it hurt. A couple more weeks, I was able to walk pretty stable, but still kind of wobbly. A couple more weeks, I was able to walk pretty normal with minimal pain. After about 5 or 6 months, I was walking, running, jogging, doing everything I was doing with no pain, just a really nasty scar. Well, after the accident, I was still in a lot of, you know, legal problems. I was in a lot of trouble when I was a kid, so I looked at my accident as my second chance at life to make a change for the better and, you know, get out of the neighborhood that I was in. I was in a really bad neighborhood surrounded by a lot of negative and bad things. So I had to do something with myself. I moved to North Jersey to get away from my neighborhood and got a job, you know, driving and operating cranes, and held down that job for a really long time. And then I found fitness. About 2.5 years ago, after I had initially gotten to the gym to try and push myself and change myself and see if I was capable of more than just walking, and I realized that I could, I took my accident and I took what I had been through and my drive to want to be a positive person, and I figured the best way that I could spread my experiences, my story, and positivity and motivation was to become a personal trainer. It's the most satisfying feeling in the world, waking up every day and loving what you do instead of waking up and dreading it. You gotta keep your head up. The biggest thing is that you gotta believe in yourself. You gotta set goals and destroy those goals. My next goal for this year, currently the biggest one that I have, is to get into schools and children's hospitals to speak with kids that are currently in wheelchairs or situations that I was in, to kind of lift them up and instill inspiration, motivation into them, and just talk to them about what I went through in hopes that it'll help them.
World's greatest. I am a mountain. I am a tall tree. Oh, I am a swift wind sweeping the country. I am a river down in the valley. Oh, I am a vision. I can see clearly. If anybody asks you who I am, just stand up tall, look them in the face and say, I'm that star up in the sky, I'm that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it. I'm the world's greatest. And I'm that little bit of hope. When my back's against the ropes, I can feel it. I'm the world's greatest. The world's greatest, Joe. The world's greatest ever. I am a giant. I am an eagle. Oh, I am a lion down in the jungle. I am a marching band. I am the people. Oh, I am a helping hand. I am a hero. If anybody asks you who I am, just stand up tall, look them in the face and say, I'm that star up in the sky, I'm that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it. I'm the world's greatest. And I'm that little bit of hope. When my back's up against the ropes, I can feel it. The world's greatest.
In the ring of life, I'll rain love.
I will rain.
And the world will notice I came.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
The world is darkness. Oh, I'll shine a light.
Shine a light.
And mirrors of success within me.
Me.
I'm that star up in the sky.
Yeah,
I'm
yeah.
That mountain peak of
high.
I
said I made it.
Greatest,
I'm that little bit.
I'm that little bit.